Everybody, welcome back to Art with Misty. Today we are going to focus on another form of printmaking. We are going to do foam plate prints at home. Using simple supplies at home, we're going to do some printmaking. Printmaking is creating an image on one surface and then transferring it to another. Foam printing is a relief printing method, which means there's higher areas, raised areas, and lower areas. The raised areas will collect the ink or the paint, and then when you print it on the paper, the lower areas will remain blank. Some of the supplies you are going to need are a paper, pen and pencil, paint or ink, and washable markers, scissors and tape, foam plates like you would eat off of, and a sponge. And make sure the sponge is wet. Let's get started. So the first thing I did was gather all the materials. I started with the paper, I keep calling it a paper plate, a foam plate. You want it to be foam because you're going to press into it. You can cut out the design of your plate however you would like. You could do a circle, a long rectangle, you could do a square. I just did a square to show you how to start. So using my scissors, I just cut out a simple shape from the center of the plate, which is the flattest area. You are also going to need the plain paper because you're going to create a stencil or a rough draft piece of paper for your design idea. So I'm going to cut the foam plate out of the center of the foam plate. So I just cut kind of an oblong rectangle. You could do other shapes like a circle or even a star. That'd be really cool. Now I'm going to create a template or a test paper for my design. So I'm going to trace the shape of my foam plate onto regular paper. Then I'm going to cut out the template so that I can draw on them. This is a great way to test out your design before you print it or press it into the foam. Because if you mess up on the paper, you don't waste the foam plate. So what I did is on the paper, I decided to use my pencil. In case I make a mistake, you can erase. And I drew some different kinds of designs. I decided to go with a flower, kind of get a little bit silly with it, add some different lines. Try to keep your design pretty simple, because if it's too complicated, it will be harder to trace. Now this is where the pen comes in handy. You're going to use the pen to trace over your pencil drawing. When you're tracing, you want to press down. That way your design is imprinted into the foam. Now it's going to be really light at first, so you're going to need to retrace over your design. Now, tracing over foam is a little bit tricky. As you can see, there's some lumps and bumps in my own design, and that's okay. Kind of makes it more unique. But if you press too hard, you could tear the foam plate. After you have it all traced, you are going to use the markers to color your design. The markers probably will dry on top of the plate, and that's okay, because there is a way of using the wet sponge to make the marker come off onto the paper when you print it, and I'll show you that in just a second. So coloring every section I want with different colors, I flip it over onto the paper. I'm just going to show you how the markers dry, so it's not going to print. Using a wet sponge, I flip the paper over, have the plate underneath the paper, and what you want to do is you want to press that wet sponge onto the paper until the image kind of shines through. If you put too much water on the plate, it will rub off. Another way you can do an imprint from your foam plate is using paint. This paint is kind of thin. It usually helps if it's thicker. And then you put it on like a stamp and peel it off. And it creates a pretty cool design. I hope you enjoy. Thank you for joining us.